Excellencies, Mrs. Rhoda Pumusime, Commissioner for Rural Economy and Agriculture of AUC, Dr. Carlos Lopez, United Nations Under Secretary General and Executive Secretary, United Nations Economic Commission for Africa, Mr. Fitas Moge, former President of Botswana, Professor Mary Robson, former Prime Minister of Ireland, Mr. Ali Abu Saba, Vice President of African Development Bank, Excellency Fellow Ministers, Honorable Savair Kasukuare, Minister of Environment, Water and Climate of Zimbabwe, Honorable Mas Aksi Gai, Minister of Fisheries and Water Resources, the Gambia, Excellency Ambassadors, Directors Generals, Distinguished Delegates, Ladies and Gentlemen, I would like to extend to you the warm greetings and welcome you all to this important conference on behalf of the government and the people of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia. It is a great honor that Ethiopia plays host to important African events such as Conference on Climate Change and Development in Africa. Because of the geography, recent progressive development activities in the country, and the peculiar vulnerability of Africa, the government and the people of Ethiopia have serious concerns about the consequences of climate variability and the climate change. Due to the special concerns we have, but also considering it is an opportunity, Ethiopia is one of the countries to set good examples in tackling the climate change issue alongside African brothers and sisters. In this light, let me mention a few. Number one, the late Prime Minister of Ethiopia, His Excellency Meles Zenawi, has provided a special leadership in global negotiation on behalf of Africa. He chaired the Committee of African Heads of State and the Government on Climate Change and played a crucial voice and respect on behalf of Africa. He articulated African concerns and influenced global agreement to understand African needs. Number two, with the Committee of African Heads of State and the Government on Climate Change Leadership, supported by the African Ministerial Conference on the Environment and the African Group of Negotiators, Africa has scored significant results in climate change negotiations. Number three, in practical terms, Ethiopia has been setting pioneer examples in addressing climate change challenges. Ethiopia has developed its climate resilient and green economy, known as CRGE strategy, alongside few countries of the world to establish such a strategy. The CRGE strategy is not an isolated and a standalone undertaking, but harmonized with and a participle of growth and the transformation plan. We are making progress in implementation of the plan through substantial and transformative progresses, such as through investment in clean and renewable energy development, increasing agricultural productivity, afforestation programs, national level public, especially the community, public mobilization, especially the communities, and the campaign to reverse degradation, improve soil and water conservation, and watershed management. Ladies and gentlemen, dissipates the historical accountability of developed nations to climate change and its impacts the common but differentiated responsibilities of nations of the world. Progress made in reversing climate change and implementing the already designed agreements are slow. All reports indicate that the average 2 degrees centigrade rise in the temperature would be surpassed unless serious actions and the commitments are made now. Exceeding the 2 degrees centigrade puts our planet in dangerous situation, and so is true for Africa. Progress made in mobilizing climate finance is slow and below expectations. The share of finance that research reaches Africa, which is the most vulnerable continent, is decimally low. Some crucial agendas, such as adaptation programs, capacity building, and technology transfer in the climate negotiations, are not getting sufficient attention. Yet we are also approaching the defining movement of 2015 at the Conference of Parties, Durban Conference in 2011. Negotiations have been launched to a new international climate change agreement covering all developing and developed countries. The 2015 agreement hopefully brings a legally binding instrument to be implemented by 2020. While these are useful mechanisms, let us now wait that and earnestly undertake defining actions that will help our future and our planet's fate. I also urge our negotiators to work tirelessly to deliver a fair deal for Africa. I urge you that this particular climate and development Africa conference take such defining challenges seriously and chart a way forward towards developing Africans' common positions, being supported by up-to-date knowledge and the results coming from such conferences. I assure you, on this occasion, the continued commitment of my government to play significant role needed to advance such interests. I also would like to acknowledge that roles of leading African institutions, the African Union Commission, the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa, the African Development Bank, and their joint program of Climate Development Africa, particularly the role played by African Climate Policy Center of United Nations ECA, is supporting the African negotiators as well as direct support to the African countries and institutions in advancing climate change and the development agenda through policy relevant research, analytical and capacity building works is highly appreciated. The work being undertaken in Ethiopia and other African countries by the African Climate Policy Center in data rescuing, climate information management, and capacity building in meteorology, hydrology, and early warning systems are quite encouraging. I urge that this be scaled up to bridge knowledge gaps between climate change and development knowledge, policy, and practice. At this juncture, I would urge you to take time to appreciate our experiences and the government's commitment in the efforts of renewable and clean energy development and engaging local communities in the global agenda of climate change in Ethiopia. Finally, I would like to appreciate the organizers of the conference, UNECA, AUC, and ADB, to bring us together to establish the continual platform for climate change debate. Last but not least, I would like to invite you to take time to visit and enjoy the flavor of the vibrant city of Addis Ababa, the headquarter of African Union Commission, and the Commission and the Economic Commission for Africa. With these brief remarks, I would like to declare the conference is open. Thank you very much.